International School Bus with a 404 engine. I've got all the spark plugs in, and I copied the firing order from the Lodestar so I could get the spark plug order set up properly, or the wire order, because before someone had removed all the spark plugs. I disconnected the fuel line, so if there's any gummy old fuel in the tank, it won't get sucked up into the carburetor. Now the only problem is we've got a leak in the cooling system somewhere, probably from a freeze plug behind the flywheel. But I think it was KJM 1983 that said it wouldn't hurt to run it just for a short while without coolant, or with just a little bit of coolant. So I'm going to give it a test here. I took this thingy off the radiator, and I filled it up with as much water as it would hold before it started running out. So we'll give it a test here. Just let it run for a short while. Let's take a look at the other side here. Got the other spark plugs in here. And still would need to hook up the air compressor output. Let's go ahead and see if it'll fire up. Pour just a little bit of gasoline in a cup here. So I'm going to pour this into the carburetor. Okay. And we'll pump the gas pedal here to get that down into the intake manifold. Okay, now here's the moment you've all been waiting for. See if it fires up. Well, I'd say that was successful. And it seems like it ran a pretty good while on that small amount of gasoline I poured down into the carburetor. So it seems like the engine is just fine. But now, just need to try to find that leak in the cooling system. I might try pouring a little more water in there, see if it runs out again. Okay, here's the water, and I'm going to try pouring it in and see how much comes out, see if it leaks at the same place. And I'm going to pour it into the radiator. And you can see, well, it's kind of hard to see it, but see the water's leaking right down there. See if I can get down under there a little bit better. It's really hard to see it, but yeah, it's all leaking out of the bell housing. So it looks like I'll get to do my first transmission removal from a bus here. Looks like it shouldn't be too difficult, but any advice you can give me on removing the transmission, I'd sure appreciate it. Looks like I probably need to support it with a jack and then just disconnect the connecting bolts to it, because it looks pretty simple in the way it's put together, and you got a lot of clearance under here. But I think if I can do that and fix that leak, this bus will run again. Certainly, this engine never would have run again had I not got to it, I'm sure. I'm sure it just would have been crushed in the junk crusher, not even tried out. So it's very promising. It seems like the engine will run okay if I can just fix the cooling system leak.